Okay, so I'm in drop detuning. I recorded about 12 minutes before this, what you're seeing now, but I was just learning how to do this. And now that I know how to do this, I'm gonna try to practice it a bit. So at first you do the A shape, just the common A, and my friend told me it's best just to keep your fingers like this. But what I like to do is go like that. It's especially important when you basically move the A shape to, I don't know if this is a sus or something, but so like, I don't know, just, well, we can see. So, so that's heart-shaped, that's the very first part. And so I already tuned it into drop D. So the sixth string has to be D instead of E. All the other strings are the same. And I'm too stupid to know if it goes E, B, or whatever. I don't know what, all I know is that usually like the standard basic tuning is this is the low E, this is the high E, and then I think this is G and this is D, I think. So I'm just gonna practice this a few times and then I'll use the tuner to get back into E instead of drop D. And that's right. So the way to get closest to the fret for me, at least on this guitar, is to hold it like that. So instead of the fingers like that, the fingers are like that. If that makes any sense? I don't know. So like, it goes ring finger on the second, middle finger on the fourth, and index on the third. So I just have to get comfortable with this. I'm basically memorizing it, so. Yeah, but this seems to move faster, so. Thank you. So that's all I'm going to do for that. And now we will use our tuner to go back into E. And for your sake, well, okay, let's spin this around. Sorry. For your sake, I'm going to pause the video while I get into E. Okay, we're back into E, and now we can just do our regular thing. So, I mean, like, I know drop D tuning is like the most common alternate tuning, and you know, it's something I had to do eventually, but I was just didn't want to do it.
Thank you.
wanted to play this. Thank you. bit of stomp fruiting with that. I can't make sense of this, so... do no fooling this time. No fooling. So, go back to this for a little bit. Mm-hmm. that is. Okay, so that's something that we don't have the strength for at the moment. And yes, of course. Okay, I think that's all I can do for now. And with the drop D part, I mean, we could try the drop D again. I'll show you how I did it, and I can undo it, and I can do anything. So we got our tuner here. We got our there, now we are in drop D, so it goes and to go back to my chart of how I am supposed to play. I might not even have it open. Okay. So we go. So that's basically the beginning. And yeah, I was gonna tune it back in front of your eyes, but I'm basically done, and I wonder if there's anything I can play in drop D that, well, that doesn't sound good. What are some things that I can play? Need the low or the deep whatever string for everything, and I'm done.